In this video, I'm going to attempt to found a parasitic ant queen. This killer invades nests and tries to overcome an already existing colony. Watch this video until the end to find out if the parasitic ant queen I captured can successfully infiltrate a nest. It all started when I was searching for queen ants this week. Currently, there are nuptial flights happening everywhere, at least here in the Netherlands. I caught a diverse amount of ants, including Lasius Umbratus. I should say a Chthonolasius species, because I don't have a microscope to ID this queen. But since Umbratus is so common in my region, I can safely say it is Umbratus. I don't say this often, but I managed to capture ant footage unlike I have ever seen. This video will have the most unique shots I ever took for an ant video. First thing I needed to do was get myself a nursery. This is a batch of pupae and workers from a wild colony that the Umbratus queen can invade. I'm choosing to take it from the wild since I don't want to sacrifice my own colonies. I brought a simple plastic tub and some test tubes. I located the Lasius flavus nest in my backyard. I had seen them many times before, and in a grassy area you can easily spot them, definitely during nuptial flights. As you can see, I'm not digging straight into the nest, but I'm carefully removing the top layer. Because of heat, the top layer of an ant nest usually contains all the pupae. So, I took some chunks of dirt filled with pupae and placed them into the tub, taking only what I need to found the parasitic ant colony. Please note that I'm not hurting the colony as a whole. Yes, I'm taking some of the pupae and workers, but this colony is really big. You can't found a parasitic ant species without brood boosting, so this is the only way. You can use Lasius Niger brood, which might be a lot easier to find. I chose Lasius flavus because there will be a time that the colony has two different workers, and because Lasius flavus is yellow, it's easy to spot the difference. Next step was separating all the pupae from the brood. This was a tedious process and took a while, but it was worth it and sped up the whole process. So for the people unaware, Lasius Umbratus is a parasitic ant species. They invade already existing nests of Lasius Niger or Lasius flavus, kill the queen and take over the colony. Founding them can be done in captivity, as I will show you today. Parasitic ant queens aren't claustral, meaning they need to be fed by workers in order to survive. You need to give them a nursery as soon as possible, otherwise your queen will die within days. After I separated all the pupae from the soil, I covered up the test tubes and let the workers do the rest. The next day, most of the brood was transported and nicely packed together. I took out the test tube and connected it to a mini outworld. Then I put in the queen and the epic intrusion could begin. She was a little nervous at first, walking around, probably smelling the colony. Then, after a couple of minutes, the first attempt was made. The queen ran into the nest. Workers were immediately on alert, trying to kill this attacker. The queen ran off and tried again. She fell into the workers and some immediately grabbed onto her limbs. But the queen tried again. Again. And again. And again. And again. I started to fear for this queen's life, as it looked rather intense. But with every attempt, she managed to spray more pheromones over the brood and workers. The queen has a very big dent in her garter. I have no idea how she got it, probably from the moment I captured her. With every attempt, the queen made more workers leave the nest. Eventually, the queen was alone with the brood. Victory? I'm not sure. Right after, the queen killed a worker. I've been told that they do this to cover themselves in the colony's scent. During queen hunting, I saw a lot of Umbratus queen carrying dead workers, so this makes sense. I put her away and gave the colony some rest. Meanwhile, I started the same process with the other queen. I put in a lot less workers and this seemed to smooth out the process by a ton. Of course, this is easier for the queen. But it also limits their chances of survival, since they really depend on the workers. The next day, I took a look at the colony again. The brownish queen seemed to be doing alright, although the workers are split up. Some remain in the outworld, while a few others are with the queen. Only time will tell how this plays out. I hope the workers will feed the queen. Same goes for the other queen. She killed some workers, but there are also some workers still alive. Problem is, they are all freshly born workers, and to me it seems like they have no clue what's going on. All the pupae are still in the outworld. Again, time will tell if the colony survives. That's why, if the colony survives, I will do an update video on the two Umbratus queens next week. I hope you're hyped for that. If you are, let me know in the comments. Thank you for watching this unique video. I hope you enjoyed it. Hopefully, I can bring you good news next week. Thank you for watching.